Frank, Jimmy White to break.
Get another chance.
Well, if Joe Johnson was disappointed not to make a maximum the last frame, certainly took it out on that red.
See if I can do it again. Please give me another chance, I think.
I'll see if I can do it again. Will you please give me another chance, he said. Only eight that time.
One. Jimmy White, 17.
Black wasn't all that easy. But now Johnson's missed two balls that he normally pots in consecutive visits to the table.
I think they're having a tea break, Clive.
Well, sometimes a reaction does set in after something tremendously exciting, like Joe Johnson's near maximum in the previous frame.
Twenty-one. 26. Joe Johnson, 27. Foul, Joe Johnson, 4.
That's going to make it difficult for Joe. But for being hampered by the green, it looked like a comparatively easy safety shot.
That's what's causing the problem. He's got to strike downwards, whichever way he looks at it.
Foul. Jimmy White.
But worse than that is that the cue ball has come away from the cushion to allow White a clear strike at this red.
Points in front now, Jimmy.
28.
Oh, he's slightly hampered.
29.
No real problem, and looks like Jimmy's frame now.
36. 37.
And only the yellow needed.
42. 44.
First three frames took only 36 minutes.
51.
This one's only been in progress 10.
56.
Half session. Jimmy White leads Joe Johnson by 3 frames to 1 at the intermission.
As quiet as possible.
And I wonder what Joe Johnson will be thinking about over his half-time cup of tea there. So nearly making a bit of history, a bit of snooker history, with only the 4th televised 147, but he missed the pink, lost the 147.